गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. थॉट ऑफ द वीक. एवरी पॉजिटिव थॉट इज अ साइलेंट प्रेयर विच विल चेंज योर लाइफ. गिवन बाय ब्रायंट मैकगिल. स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस पीरियड वी हैव जस्ट स्टार्टेड न्यू लेसन, दैट इज लेसन नंबर 4, ऑपरेशंस ऑन फ्रैक्शंस. नाउ लेट्स सी द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इन दिस लेसन, एंड दैट इज कन्वर्शन ऑफ एन इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन इनटू अ मिक्स नंबर. Now students, in the previous period I have already explained you what is improper fraction and a mixed number. A fraction where numerator is greater than denominator is called as an improper fraction, whereas a fraction which is made up of a complete number, that is integral part, and a fraction, that is fractional part, is called as a mixed number. Let's see example. If 7 apples are divided equally between 2 people, how many will each one get? You have to divide 7 apples into 2 people equally, therefore 7 upon 2, which also means that 7 divided by 2. Therefore, we have to divide 7 by 2. 2 threes are 6, and 7 minus 6 gives you 1. The biggest number to which we are going to divide by 2 is called as dividend. The number by which we are dividing 7 is called as divisor. The answer of the division is called as the quotient, and the number which is left over is called as the remainder. Therefore, 7 upon 2, which is an improper fraction, can be written as mixed number as 3 integer 1 upon 2. So each will get three full apples and 1.5 apple. Note, while dividing, we take care to see that the remainder is smaller than the divisor. Students, what they say, we are going to take care that remainder is always smaller than the divisor. Therefore, while dividing, we take care to see that the remainder is smaller than the divisor. As a result, in the mixed number, the numerator of the fractional part is smaller than its denominator. Here you can see this. Since the remainder is smaller than the divisor, therefore here the numerator of the mixed number is less than the denominator of the fraction. Now, next concept, conversion of a mixed number into an improper fraction. Means this concept is exactly opposite of the first one. Let's see example. Conversion of a mixed number into an improper fraction. Example, 3 integer 2 upon 5 is a mixed number. Convert this into an improper fraction. Now students, let's see the method. 3 integer 2 upon 5 is equal to, what does it means? 3 is a complete number and 2 upon 5 represents a fractional part. Therefore, this can be written as 3 plus 2 upon 5. Here 3 is a complete number, therefore no denominator below 3. So we can write this number as 3 upon 1, which does not change its numerical value, plus 2 upon 5. Now you know that in the 5th standard we have seen that unless and until the denominators of the two given fractions are equal or same, it is not possible for us to make addition or any other operation of the same. Therefore, here we have to make the denominator same. Then here the denominator of the first fraction is 1, whereas the denominator of the second fraction is 5. So if we multiply the first fraction, that is numerator and denominator of the first fraction, by 5, we get the denominator of the first fraction as 5. Therefore, 3 multiplied by 5 upon 1 multiplied by 5 plus second fraction as it is. 3 multiplied by 5 gives you 15, and 1 into 5 gives you 5 plus second fraction as it is. Therefore, now the denominators of both these fractions are same, therefore it is possible for us to do the addition. Therefore 15 plus 2 upon 5, 15 plus 2 17, therefore our answer is 17 upon 5. But for the conversion of this mixed number into an improper fraction, we have followed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 steps, and it is little bit tedious and time consuming. Therefore, we are going to follow the second method. Here, what you have to do, this is a mixed number as it is given. Same example, we are going to see 3 integer 2 upon 5. What you have to do, you have to do the multiplication of 5 into 3, and to the product of these two numbers, you have to add 2. That's why I have shown here 5 into 3 plus 2 upon 5 is equal to 5 into 3 gives you 15 plus 2 upon 5 is equal to 17 upon 5. So students, instead of doing 5 steps, it is possible for us to convert the mixed number into improper fraction by doing only 2 steps. Therefore, this method is convenient for us. In the next PPT, we are going to solve practice set 9. So, complete this work in your copy. Write down the given material from all the slides in your copy. And let's see the next video for the practice set 9. Thank you.